Thanks to Linode Cloud Computing for supporting this episode of SciShow. You can go to linode.com/scishow to learn more and get a $100 60-day credit on a new Linode account. Now, some people might dream of getting the chance to live in a Martian colony. Others might find that a nightmare. But everyone's probably worried about the food that they'd have to eat. In sci-fi movies, space colonists usually have to eat some shelf-stable protein bars or food pellets, but what if they want, like, a salad? Unfortunately, that colony is probably underground to keep everyone safe from cosmic radiation. Add in the super-thin atmosphere and the lack of liquid water, and it's pretty clear that those salads are gonna have to be grown indoors, without sunlight. And while we can currently grow plants in those conditions, we're not that great at it. But it turns out, scientists are working on ways to grow crops in total darkness. One of the biggest problems with growing food indoors is that, despite being around for more than 3.4 billion years, photosynthesis still isn't very efficient. Photosynthesis takes water, carbon dioxide, and the energy-carrying particles of light, called photons, and turns them into sugar molecules that the plant can use to live and grow. But when that source of light is the sun, most crop plants only turn about 1% of that energy into what we can harvest. So to feed an entire population, you need a lot of room to grow, a lot of plants that have a lot of leaves to take in a lot of sunlight. And if you're living on Mars, all that stuff can be hard to come by. Over the years, scientists have tried to improve the efficiency of photosynthesis by using selective breeding and genetic engineering to make little tweaks to various parts of the process. But one team decided to bypass photosynthesis entirely. Instead of plants using light to make their own food, the team found a way to make food using the exact same ingredients – water, carbon dioxide, and energy. But the energy comes from electricity. In a process called electrocatalysis, that electricity breaks apart the water and CO2 molecules to convert them into oxygen gas and acetate, which is the main ingredient in vinegar. After the researchers mix the acetate with some additional nutrients, a plant could absorb the new food source with its roots. The plant can then use the carbon from the acetate in the same way that it would use the carbon in the sugars produced by photosynthesis. So this electrocatalysis replaces the inefficient steps of photosynthesis, but it still provides a plant, or really any life form that relies on photosynthesis, the chemical elements it needs to grow. Using this acetate-enriched food, the researchers were able to grow things like algae and yeast in total darkness, and both grew more than they would have using their natural photosynthesis powers. The algae grew 4 times as much, and the yeast yield was 18 times larger. Now, the researchers also gave the acetate to plants, like rice, peas, tomatoes, peppers, and lettuce, but those weren't grown in the dark. The team was just testing to make sure the crops could incorporate the carbon from the acetate like they could with the carbon from their homemade sugar. To track that, the team used a heavier form of carbon to make the acetate. That allowed them to track how much acetate these plants used, along with the sugars they made from photosynthesis. As for why they didn't just grow the plants in the dark, well, the paper doesn't really say. But in the end, all these crops did use the acetate to varying degrees. So if things are looking good for growing crops in less space and in controlled environments like buildings, why aren't we using this amazing method already? Well, it turns out the team did have some struggles growing their crops. When they tested different concentrations of acetate on the lettuce, the plants given the highest concentrations turned out pretty wimpy, instead of growing way bigger. That includes both the leafy salad parts as well as the roots. The team suggested it might be the potassium in the acetate solution that's stunting the growth. Even so, the results aren't thorough enough for farmers to start dumping a bunch of acetate on their crops and expecting them to grow better. But with genetic engineering, researchers could develop plants that are better at incorporating acetate into their overall structure. And if this new photosynthesis-skipping process actually does work, space colonists won't be the only ones who can grow food indoors and in more concentrated spaces. Cities don't have the space to grow enough food for their entire populations, so produce often has to be shipped in from far away. But if they could grow crops indoors, cities might be able to produce enough food locally, which would mean fresher, cheaper, and more sustainable meals. And as climate change threatens agriculture around the world, indoor farms might help stem the tide of food scarcity. Now, technically, the current version of this process still uses sunlight at some point in the process because the electricity that created the acetate was generated by solar panels. But there's no reason that it has to use light. For example, future Martian colonists may get some of their power from miniature nuclear fission reactors. So, like with all experimentation, it will take some time to work out the kinks, but one day scientists might finally see the fruits of their labor, and grown without a drop of sunlight. Now, whether you're growing food far away or just getting your online cloud connection from far away, things are just simpler when they're closer to you. Which is why Linode Cloud Computing has 11 data centers all across the world so that you can get the best connection through the data center closest to you. Linode is a cloud computing provider that brings online firewall protection to you internationally. They're there to ensure your projects are safe, whether you live in Singapore, Toronto, or anywhere in between. And they keep your work safe through cloud firewall protection. This feature regulates traffic to and from your projects by only allowing your specific trusted IP addresses through. And you can use the same safety rules for different applications, so you don't have to sit there and type out every IP address you trust every time you start a new project. Linode makes it a process that scales in seconds. And you don't need to learn how to do it using a command line. Linode Cloud Computing makes the process way more user-friendly, and they even provide a video to explain the whole thing. So for you to access safe cloud storage all over the world, you just have to click the link in the description or head to linode.com/scishow for a $100 60-day credit on a new Linode account. Thank you to Linode Cloud Computing for supporting the SciShow video, and thank you for watching.